At what point must a female senator raise her hand or her voice to be recognized over the male colleagues in the room?
Welcome back to State of Texas In Depth. You just heard the Democrat running for lieutenant governor during an all-night filibuster of abortion restrictions led by her Senate colleague, Wendy Davis. Since that night, both women have become a powerhouse for their party in Texas and nationwide. This week, Vandepute stopped by our studio to talk about her campaign for the state's second highest office.
It's important not just to me as chair of the committee in the Senate of Veteran Affairs and Military Installations, but Texas is a very patriotic state. We have over 1.8 million veterans and their families, 15 military installations with active duty personnel, and 22,000 fighting forces. That's your Texas National Guard. So for Texas, being the state where veterans and their families and active duty military and their families can call home is a priority, because we want to be the number one state for these group of people. They have given so much for us that it's more than a bumper sticker or saying thank you. We have to have policy that reflects the importance of this population.
Seems like there has seemed to be a sparring match between you and the lieutenant governor regarding this issue, especially when it comes to Democratic chairs of committees and maybe the importance of the particular committee you chair.
Well, I think the lieutenant governor, and I am thankful that he has appointed me as chair for now 10 years on this committee, because it's the committee and the legislature that's done the work. But I think what he was trying to say was that he would not appoint Democrats to important committees. And I understand if he wants to minimize my role in the legislature or that of Democrats, but to say that the committee on veteran affairs and military installations is not important is, well, just ask anybody who's had to pray every single day that their family member comes back safely from Iraq and Afghanistan. Talk to those mothers and brothers and sisters and spouses. They know our military is important, and they really don't care if it's a Republican or a Democrat heading that chair. They want us to do the work that honors the sacrifice that their families have made to this country. And that's what I focus on. So although the target may have been me, what he really dissed was our veterans.
You don't think his explanation that maybe he was misunderstood and that it was just a comment he wanted to say to make sure that this was a bipartisan committee stands?
No, what he said was Democrats only chaired unimportant committees, not committees that do the meaningful work. Well, I think the work of the committee has been meaningful. You know, the two constitutional amendments we had last legislative session, the first on a property tax exemption for those surviving spouses of those killed in action, that's important. That's important to Texans. It was passed overwhelmingly. So what he said was pretty clear.
On the GOP side of this race, it seems like a runoff is going to be likely, and a lot of people think that Mr. Dewhurst will be in that runoff. If he makes it past that runoff, how do you think a match between you and him will play out?
Well, I'm going to be ready for whoever comes out of that Republican primary and the runoff. I'm running not just for this position. I really want this responsibility. Been a legislator for 23 years, but it's basically what I feel is important that families have told me important. It's an education system that prepares our workforce. It's concentrating on our highways so that we're not talking about turning them into gravel. And it's securing our water projects for the future. If you don't have water, you don't have jobs. Those are the things that I'm going to be focused on, and I've always worked in a bipartisan fashion to get results. That's what I would do as lieutenant governor. And so I'll be ready for whoever the Republican nominee is.
When it comes to gay marriage, that has been a topic that has been brought up a lot in the news in the last couple of weeks. One of the GOP candidates, Todd Staples, actually authored the amendment to make marriage between a man and a woman recognized in the state of Texas. Do you feel like that this is going to be something that you will have to address in your campaign?
Well, I know that people will make this an issue in the campaign, and I will always fall on the side of equality. People should be judged for their employment and for their housing and for the basic civil rights by their job skills, by what they do in the community, not on who they love. And I think people are changing. I mean, this constitutional amendment was passed. I voted against it because I really felt that people need to be honored in the fashion that they make their individual decisions. And this is the last part for me of civil rights. I am a believer in equal rights for all people, and that means that we support equality.
So you support gay marriage?
Absolutely support gay marriage. I've got to tell you that probably 20 years ago, I thought that civil unions would be the right way to go rather than marriage. But what this is a government recognizes the commitment that two individuals make to each other. And it is a commitment that they make willingly. I think that government's recognition of two people making that commitment should be the same, whether it's a man and a woman, whether it's two men or two women. I mean, it is two people that make that commitment. And I've got to tell you, I've evolved on it because I thought, well, there ought to be marriage and there ought to be like a civil union that people can designate their partner. But I think you ought to be able to have full equality. If not, then we really don't live in that free country.
Your Democratic colleague that's running for the governorship, she has also spoken out about gay marriage. She's also spoken out about marijuana here in Texas, supporting the possibility of medicinal marijuana. How do you feel on that issue?
Well, I think we ought to listen to physicians. I think we ought to listen to the medical community. We have not had the opportunity to have those types of hearings in the Senate, and I think we ought to see what the statistics are. What I know that even the work of the Department of Defense is now using medical marijuana for post-traumatic stress. We've heard of those reports. I think it's time to look at that and to bring it up. I've got to tell you, though, that I think that there's a big difference between the medical use of marijuana and the full legalization of marijuana. That is something that is a very different topic. Again, something that the legislature really has not delved into.
Now, what would you say about the non-medicinal support of marijuana?
Well, I'm a healthcare professional, and for the last 30 years, I have been absolutely strong on the use of reducing cigarette use. That's a combustible botanical product. And I don't know what the data tells us about use of another combustible botanical product in marijuana for recreational use, for long-term use, what it does to impairment. And I really would be worried about the message that we give our children that we've gone so far and reduced the rates of smoking uptake because of health reasons, that we are at a point to we say, well, it's okay to smoke a joint, but it's not okay to smoke a cigarette. And so I would really like to look at what the medical professionals, what implications there are, and to tell you, it's not really a subject that has been brought up. But at this point, I am not in favor of legalization of marijuana simply because of the effect, long-term of effect, it would have on our youth.
Beyond those issues, Democrats seem to have a lot riding on you and Wendy Davis right now. What if you guys aren't successful? What do you think happens to the Democratic movement here in Texas?
I think the Democratic Party, you know, we've seen swings in the electorate from Democrat to Republican. But I'm going to tell you, even Democrats 30 years ago were very, very conservative. Texas has always been a state that has valued hard work. That's not going to change. It's Republican or Democrat. But what I think most people understand is that right now that there is a magnet pulling Republicans way to one extreme, and they're not focusing on the mainstream issues that Texas government ought to be focused on. And that's a quality education, college that's affordable and within reach, a highway system that can meet the needs of a 21st century economy, and the water projects that we need to secure jobs for the future. Those are the things that people want us to concentrate on. So as Democrats, we're going to make that case. It just so happens that Wendy and I both happen to be gals, right? We're both females, and we're very pro-public education. I think that whether you're a Democrat or a Republican, and whether we fall short or not, it's still going to be the same families talking about the issues that are important to them. I'm going to be in the Senate come January 2015. I hope to be on that dais as a leader that can bring people together to look at what Texas challenges are and to sit down together and find the best solutions. That's the type of person that I would be in that dais as lieutenant governor. But make no doubt about it, Leticia Vanderpoot is going to be in the Senate come 2015.
Coming up, our political roundtable breaks down the race for lieutenant governor and the primary less than 2 weeks away. Morgan Smith from our media partner, the Texas Tribune, and Brian Sweeney from Texas Monthly, when State of Texas In Depth returns.